A very good morning to all. Myself, I am Vinod. I am an assistant professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering in Jerusalem College of Engineering for past 14 years. So let us today discuss about the embedded system in smart card. So an introduction is, smart card is a device which includes embedded integrated circuits that can be either a secure microcontroller or equivalent intelligence with its internal memory. We all know what is a smart card is. Smart card is nothing but we use for our ATM banks, ATMs where you transact through your ATM. Okay, so purpose we should know. If you have an account, then there should be an authentication for that, and only you have to use that particular account. So we will, verification process will be there so that it will allow you to use it. The host machine, which is nothing but the ATM machine, will have graphical user interface. So with the card holder and this host machine, we are able to do the transaction. So this is our card. So card has a three layers. One hidden layer. That hidden layer is nothing but where it has all the embedded thing in it. Okay, embedded, we have already seen a particular microcontroller or a microprocessor used for that particular application alone. We call it as embedded. That software is being embedded inside that controller for that task alone. So now how this embedded is going to get connected and communicate? So it is able to connect with this contact pad. So this pad, we might have all seen, it will be like in a golden shape, which is visible on the ATM card. Okay, previously we were using magnetic tapes. Now the magnetic tapes are replaced. So only you have a smart card with this contact pad. Okay, so this will have a contact with the underlying microcontroller based your board. And this coil like structure is nothing but antennas. Nowadays, even you don't want to insert your card, just place your card about that machine. It automatically senses through the help of Wi-Fi. So that Wi-Fi is being enabled with this antenna which is there inside your smart card. Okay, so let us move on to the next one. Is what is this contact pad? So this contact pad, we are able to visualize that you will have a ground pin, you will have VCC pin. VCC pin is nothing but supply which is required for the embedded to operate inside your smart card. Then you have a person called reset. So this we all know, reset is nothing but starting from first. And when you want to write a program inside your smart card, you see, smart card is given from the corresponding bank. That corresponding bank fellow, for your authentication, your code will be written inside the smart card with the help of this particular pin. Only at that duration of time we will give a supply to this pin, so that content will be written inside your smart card. Okay, then this is input output. Here you go for only serial communication, so only bitwise serial communication will take inside your smart card. And when you talk about a person is going to be operated in synchronism, then you should have a person called clock. So it is serial communication with the clock. So it is a synchronous serial communication. Okay, then this is, we all see that it is reserved for further use. Till now this pin is not been used. So totally you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 pins. So in among 8 pins, we have seen what are all each pin is for. So this will be prevailing in your smart card. Okay, so let us start with the function of the system. The card insert at the host machine. So you will go take the card and insert inside your ATM machine. Okay, the radiation from the host activate a charge pump at the card. That machine has to give the supply to your ATM card. That is what we have written here. We call it as pumping charge and all, but simply to identify, it is nothing but from the machine is giving supply to the card. The charge pump process the SOC circuit. This system on chip, the inside your smart card you have a system. Okay, that system is for that particular smart card application alone. That is why we call it as system on chip circuit consisting card processor. So this system will have a card processor, memory unit it will have, timers it will have, interrupt. We all know what is meant by timer, and timer is nothing but for each and every process we will give allotted time. Within that time you have to do. If you take more time, then automatically it will say time request out, and again you have to remove the card and do the process. This is for just for an authentication and a security. Okay, then interrupts is you will have some types of interrupts. Suddenly we identify that some other person is using, or there is doubt. In that case interrupt will come, and that interrupt will try to bring it out. So this is general. Now let us start with what is the sequence which is taking. We all know for an embedded system there should be n number of tasks. You know task. Task is nothing but a small program. So small program will be combined and we call it as an embedded system. So once the ATM card, I say ATM card, but it is a smart card, okay? So once you give this ATM card inside your ATM machine, the first step will be reset task. Reset task will start, and this reset task, what it will do is, it will start the program from the first. Once the reset task is sent, the message request header and request start for waiting task, automatically it will move on to the next task, which is nothing but task read port. So this task read port is nothing but it will read what and all content inside your smart card will be read by the ATM machine. Then once that is read, then ATM machine has to get the password. So for that you will have a task. So what task and all is completed? Reset task is completed, read port is complete. Once you have read the port, next thing is you have to go for password. So that through input output, I think we have seen that there is a pin called input output. Through this input output port, this particular smart card will try to ask the password. So once the person who enters correct password, then it will go to task application. Task application is nothing but you are going to withdraw or you are going to do any transaction, that will do. So these are the tasks inside your smart card. So again I will repeat, there are tasks which is called as reset task, then read port task, then your password task, then your application task. Card now been withdrawn, all transaction between card holder user and the task placed through the GUI is completed. Once the application is over, you will take back the card from the machine. Okay, so I repeat, task communication, there are reset task, then port read, you have to read the port and get the data, which is nothing but your account number. All such details will be taken by the host system. Then it will ask for password, that program will be run where you have to type your pins, that will get the input and that will be taken into smart card for verification. Then your application, okay, except this task reset, for each and other task you have called as ISR, which is interrupt service routine. So whenever you move from one task to another task, this is nothing but an interrupt. So interrupt will change to the next application. So totally three is there, okay. Now let us see about what is the hardware present inside your smart card. So hardware present inside your smart card is nothing but you will have a CPU, followed by you will have a RAM, you will have port, input output ports. Ports is nothing but we all know it is the place where the data gets transferred, similar to the port what we see in Arbor. What is the port for the function in Arbor? It will get the material or it will upload the material to the ship, okay. Similar way you have ports here. Then trans receiver, which is nothing but an IC which is used to transmit as well as receive. So this is your host machine. So I will repeat, you will have an CPU. For CPU you should have a RAM, that is nothing but a memory where all the contents is being stored. Input output port is a place where either data goes out or data comes in. Then you will have a trans receiver, which is nothing but an IC which is going to transmit serially data outwards. So we have already seen it is serial communication, that also you are going to do with synchronization, okay. Now for all this you require power supply, so that is nothing but your VCC. So VCC, I think you have seen this here. So you have a VCC. So from that VCC you will get the power, and that is been charge pump is nothing but VCC level will be minimum. Now you try to do some time of amplification, so you amplify, then use the power, okay. This flash memory will be used only by the bank, where they will write your account number, your details to your smart card. So this will be used only at the time of issue. Thereafter you cannot touch this. We can touch only RAM and CPU, okay. So this is with respect to hardware. And there is always, see, when you manufacture anything, you should follow some standards. Here there are standards for smart card is ISO. So that smart card is nothing going to tell about what is the length of the card, what is the width of the card, and what is the height of the card. So this is length, this is breadth, and this is your thickness. It is embedded SoC, system on chip, ISO standard. So now smart card is available in two versions. One is with Wi-Fi mode, another one is chip mode. So for Wi-Fi mode, you have another number which is called 14443, which is for non-contactless card. Non-contactless, we know that there is no need to have any contact. You just transfer via wireless. Okay, so when you want to go for wireless smart card, then related things is being published in ISO 14443. Whereas normal case with the help of chip, you go for ISO 7816. Okay. Then the microcontroller which is being used is MC68H or PIC microcontroller, or Philips has developed some controllers for your smart card. And this, I think you all know what is ASIP, which is nothing but application specification instruction processor, which means this processor and all will not have the normal instruction. It will have only instruction related to smart card purpose. Okay, so that is what it has been mentioned. The memory, you will have usually 8K memory inside plus an internal RAM of 32 KB. Okay, then CPU clocks certain section of memory. This is for its own purpose, protect 1K data is being totally there. Then standard ROM, random access memory, and read-only memory. There are two types, and this is your read-only memory which is being used by the card manufacturer. They itself will try to do. Then chip supply system using charge pump. This charge pump is nothing but an amplifier circuit which will amplify the voltage from your host machine to the required level. Okay, now we will, let us see about application of smart card. So we have seen what is a basic, then what is the hardware requirement and all. Now application is, smart card has been used in bank, medical health cards, satellite TV cards like dish TV cards, access control system in all your industries where the employee is given with access control system. Then electronic cash, wireless communication is nothing but smart card second version. Previous version came with chip, now it is with wireless. Government identification like Aadhaar card, or Aadhaar card has not yet come with chip. You have like what to say, your license, where that is come with a smart card. Then for telecommunication purpose, and ticketless travel system where you will given with a smart card, like what is there in metro, we will given a smart card. With the help of that smart card, you can travel, then no need to buy a ticket and waste the papers. So advantage, you have security, so smart card are more secure. Then smart card are small in size and it is convenient, you can carry. Economically friendly, that smart card helps in your economy by reducing transaction cost by eliminating papers. You don't want to use papers. Then multifunction, or single card can be used for so many purpose, so you don't want to carry so many things with you. Well, just a smart card is more than sufficient that you can use it for many purpose. Reliable, whenever you use it will get used, and that is why previously we have magnetic strips that may get damaged due to keeping in your wallet and all. Now this will be more reliable, smart card will not get damaged easily. Okay, thank you. So I like you to request, after watching, please give your comments on YouTube. Please share your views on the YouTube. Thank you.